The Origin of the Family, Private Property, and the State by Friedrich Engels is a groundbreaking work that delves into the intricate evolution of human social structures. Written in 1884, this text is a fundamental piece in the Marxist literature, providing a detailed materialist analysis of the origins and development of the family, private property, and the state. Engels, drawing heavily on anthropologist Lewis H. Morgan's research, offers a compelling narrative on how economic and material conditions shape social institutions and their transformations over time. Historical materialism and social evolution. Engels begins his exploration by introducing the concept of historical materialism, a key principle in Marxist theory. According to this framework, the mode of production in any given society, how goods are produced and distributed, determines the structure of that society and its superstructures, including politics, law, and ideology. Engels argues that changes in the economic base inevitably lead to transformations in the social and political superstructure. This approach allows Engels to trace the development of human societies from primitive communism through various stages of social and economic complexity. The gens and early social organization. In the earliest stages of human history, Engels posits that societies were organized into gens, or clan-based groups. These groups were characterized by communal ownership of resources and an egalitarian social structure. The gens system was based on kinship, with social relations rooted in mutual aid and collective decision-making. Engels uses Morgan's studies of Native American tribes to illustrate the characteristics of these early communal societies. In these groups, there was no concept of private property or state authority. Social cohesion was maintained through kinship ties and collective responsibilities. The transition to private property. The shift from communal ownership to private property marks a critical juncture in human history. Engels argues that this transition was driven by the development of productive forces, particularly agriculture and animal domestication. As these new modes of production created surplus goods, the need to control and distribute resources led to the emergence of private property. This shift resulted in the division of labor and social stratification, with some individuals accumulating wealth and power while others became subjugated. The rise of private property, Engels contends, laid the foundation for class divisions and economic exploitation. The evolution of the family. Alongside the development of private property, the structure of the family also underwent significant changes. In primitive communal societies, the family was based on collective living arrangements and communal child-rearing practices. However, as private property became more prominent, the family structure evolved to ensure the inheritance of property through male lineage. This transformation led to the establishment of patriarchal authority, where men gained control over the family and its resources. Engels argues that the oppression of women is deeply connected to the rise of private property and the patriarchal family system, which emerged to safeguard property and ensure legitimate heirs. The emergence of the state. The establishment of private property and social hierarchies inevitably led to conflicts over resources and power. To manage these conflicts and maintain social order, the state emerged as a distinct institution. Engels asserts that the state serves the interests of the ruling class by protecting private property and perpetuating social inequality. He traces the development of the state from its rudimentary forms in ancient societies to more complex structures in feudal and capitalist societies. The state, according to Engels, is an instrument of class rule, designed to maintain the dominance of the propertied class over the propertyless. Critique of bourgeois historiography. Throughout his work, Engels critiques bourgeois historiography, which he argues distorts historical facts to justify the existing social order. Bourgeois historians, he claims, often overlook or minimize the role of economic factors and class struggle in shaping historical events. Engels' materialist approach, in contrast, emphasizes the significance of production and property relations in understanding historical developments. By focusing on the material conditions that give rise to social institutions, Engels provides a more comprehensive and critical analysis of history. The role of women in primitive societies. Engels pays particular attention to the role of women in primitive societies, arguing that they held a more equal and often superior position compared to later patriarchal societies. In the gens system, lineage was typically matrilineal, and women played crucial roles in social and economic life. The transition to patriarchal systems marked a significant decline in the status of women, who were increasingly relegated to domestic roles and subjected to male authority. Engels' analysis highlights the profound impact of economic and social changes on gender relations and the status of women. The impact of technological advancements. Technological advancements, particularly in agriculture and metallurgy, played a pivotal role in the transformation of social structures. The development of tools and techniques for farming and animal husbandry allowed for the production of surplus goods, which in turn facilitated the accumulation of private property. These advancements also contributed to the division of labor and the emergence of specialized professions, further entrenching social hierarchies. Engels emphasizes that technological progress is not neutral, it shapes and is shaped by the economic and social relations of the time. The state and class struggle. Engels argues that the state is inherently tied to class struggle. In every historical epoch, the state functions as an instrument of class rule, designed to suppress the interests of the oppressed classes and maintain the dominance of the ruling class. This perspective challenges traditional views of the state as a neutral arbiter of social conflicts. Engels contends that true social emancipation can only be achieved through the abolition of the state and the establishment of a classless society. This revolutionary outlook is a central tenet of Marxist theory, advocating for the overthrow of capitalist systems and the creation of a communist society, the dialectical process of social change. Engels employs the dialectical method to analyze social change, viewing history as a dynamic and contradictory process. According to this method, social development occurs through the resolution of contradictions within the existing system, leading to the emergence of new social forms. Engels applies this framework to various historical transitions, such as the shift from feudalism to capitalism. He argues that capitalism, like previous systems, contains inherent contradictions that will ultimately lead to its downfall and the rise of socialism. The dialectical approach underscores the inevitability of social transformation driven by material conditions. Legacy and influence. The origin of the family, private property, and the state has had a profound impact on social and economic thought. Engels' materialist analysis of history has influenced a wide range of disciplines, including anthropology, sociology, and political science. His work has inspired generations of scholars and activists to critically examine the economic foundations of social institutions and to advocate for social change. Despite its historical context, Engels' insights into the interplay between economic factors and social structures remain relevant in contemporary debates about inequality, gender relations, and the role of the state. In The Origin of the Family, Private Property, and the State, Friedrich Engels provides a thorough and thought-provoking analysis of the evolution of human social institutions. By employing a materialist approach, Engels reveals the underlying economic forces that drive social change and shape the development of the family, private property, and the state. His work challenges conventional historical narratives and offers a critical perspective on the origins of social inequality and the mechanisms of class rule. Engels' contributions to the understanding of social history continue to resonate, offering valuable insights for those seeking to comprehend and transform the world around them. Engels' examination of the gens system and early social organization underscores the importance of communal living and collective responsibility in primitive societies. His analysis of the rise of private property and the patriarchal family illuminates the profound social and economic transformations that accompanied these developments. By tracing the emergence of the state as an instrument of class rule, Engels provides a compelling critique of the relationship between power and property. Throughout the text, Engels' commitment to a materialist conception of history challenges readers to reconsider the origins and functions of social institutions. His work highlights the interconnectedness of economic, social, and political factors in shaping human history. As a foundational text in Marxist theory, The Origin of the Family, Private Property, and the State remains an essential resource for understanding the dynamics of social change and the struggle for social justice. In conclusion, Engels' work is not only a historical analysis but also a call to action. By exposing the material conditions that give rise to social inequality, Engels advocates for a revolutionary transformation of society. His vision of a classless society, free from the constraints of private property and state oppression, continues to inspire movements for social and economic justice. The Origin of the Family, Private Property, and the State is a timeless and influential work that challenges us to rethink our understanding of history and to envision a more equitable future.